Tell me what wrestler used to do that, and also what wrestler said, everyone's got a prize. See how many people out there know. Put your answers in the comments below, and I'll read them. And as usual, if you like what this video is going to have to say, then give me a thumbs up and share it. And if you're new, please subscribe and hit the bell notification button so you always get my videos, or at least notified when I make them. This video, I've been doing some thinking on, and well, I think it's a pretty easy video to see the difference between two different parties that seem like they're similar, but in reality, couldn't be further from each other. The parties I'm talking about, well, they're simple. It's quite simple. I'm talking about the Liberal Party, and then what everyone's come to be called to call the Libtard Party. Now, to someone who doesn't know, they sound and seem very, very similar. Rights for gays and women, but it's not the case. You see, liberals, the true liberals, are what the hippies back in the day were. Let me mute this here. They were true liberals. They wanted smaller government, more individual rights, you know, the government basically staying the fuck out of our lives and not telling us how to try to run our own lives and, you know, letting us be happy. They were, you know, the whole, you know, Constitution believing and everything. However, the Libtard Party, as I call them, and a lot of other conservatives call them, is the exact opposite. They want big business through government control. They want rights for everyone, but the government controls everything. They want the government to pay for college for everybody. The government to pay for everybody to have health care. The government to give you money whether you can work or not. If you choose to not work, hey, don't worry. You get paid the same amount as the guy that's working, and it's all good in the hood. Free housing for everybody. Basically, they want the government to control everything and to give everybody the basic needs, you know, housing, food, shelter, water, and to take care of us. However, the countries that have truly tried this, aka Russia back when they were communistic, Cuba, Korea, Venezuela, Vietnam, Cambodia, Burma to a certain extent, China for the longest, and others, didn't fare out so well. They all ended up going to capitalism or the free market society or a variation of the free market society. Every time. Or, as in the case with Venezuela, Cuba, North Korea. Well, maybe not North Korea, but North Korea is a shithole for the people, the common people who live there. But for the rich, hey, it's a great place. But we'll get into that more later. Alright. Venezuela, Cuba, they're bankrupt. They're fucking done. I mean, look at them. They're done. In Venezuela, people are killing each other over toilet paper. They're eating their dogs, their cats, their guinea pigs, whatever the hell they can find, roadkill. I mean, anything to stay alive. And that's what the libtards want. That's what Antifa, BAM, groups like that, and people like Chuck Schumer, Nancy Pelosi, and Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez wants. However, especially in the case of Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, she never tells you how much it's gonna cost. She just wants all the shit. Free. She wants everyone to go green in 10 years, and she doesn't mention how it's gonna cost or how she's gonna get the money to pay for it. But when you bring it up, you're racist, you're stupid, you're uninformed. You see, another difference between the true blue liberals, or in this case, true red liberals, was that even though they may disagree with you, you were still able to sit down and have a nice debate, or at least a very nice conversation with them. They would listen to your points of view, and they would make their case by stating their points of view, and at the end of it, either their minds would be changed, your mind would be changed, or everybody would agree to disagree on that topic. But another sign that someone is a libtard, not even a liberal, because the liberals back in the day, you know, the two liberals, you can actually have a conversation with them. But the libtards, you know, two signs that someone's a libtard, it's simple. You can't have a conversation with them. All they want to do is scream, hoot, holler, yell, call you names, cuss you out, say you this, say you that. When you're not. Alright. That's what they want to do. And I need to check some of my remotes. You have to bear with me. Okay, it still works. Okay. I'm trying to get my remote to do something here, and it's not, so it. Oh, that's why it's not. Yeah, okay. I'm a dumbass. I just had a blah moment. Been up for 6 days. What do you expect? My brain's starting to get a little sluggish. But the liberals, like that you could talk to, discuss things with, and there was that mutual. Even if they didn't believe the way you did, didn't like how you believed, didn't like your thought processes or something or whatever, didn't like your politics or whatever, there was a mutual understanding that in order to have a conversation, everybody has to start out with mutual respect. I'll respect you and your points of view. And I'll listen to your ideas as long as they're well thought out and intelligent and logical. And then when you're done and I've listened to all your ideas, I will make my ideas known and my cite my information and where I get it and why I feel the way I do and the way I think about things the way I do is more adequate and correct way of saying it. And at the end of the day, if I've changed your ideas or the way you think about something, good. If I haven't, hey, we can still be friends and we still have that mutual respect for one another. But with libtards, it's truly all about how they feel. There is no facts for them. They cannot state facts, or they will not state facts. And if you start pushing facts, you start mentioning the facts, such as factual statistics about police shootings and African Americans versus police shootings with white people. You know, if you push, if you tell them how factually through the FBI's own database and everything, a white person is 10 times more likely to be shot and killed by a police officer than an African American is. They don't want to hear that. Oh, God. No. See, you came at them with facts. So, because you came at them with facts, they consider that you aggressed them. You came at them aggressively. You did what they call microaggressions towards them. So you must be a racist or a liar or a Trump supporter, which I don't understand how they say calling someone a Trump supporter is an insult. But that's what they do. You know, every time, without fail, if you try to bring facts into it, you, not them, you are in the wrong. You are a Nazi. You are the one trying to shut down their free speech. You are the one who is a white supremacist. It doesn't matter to them if you're black. You're still a white supremacist, which, if you ask me, that's a cute fucking trick. To be black and a white supremacist, because last time I understood white supremacist, it meant a white guy who hates niggers, specs, wops, greasers, nips, gooks, chinks, and fucking only likes white people. That's my understanding of white supremacist. A white person that will have nothing to do with any race other than, in their eyes, the superior race, aka the white race. Because in their minds, we're superior, and hey, that's how it is. Niggers can't win against a white man unless they use a weapon in a fight, and all kinds of weird, fucked up ideas. And I'm not saying that they're right, because I've been on the end of racism. I grew up in Texas, originally. So I've went against the Klan and their children and all that. Had crosses burnt in front of my home. Okay, the whole night. Had death threats, been in numerous fights, because growing up, I had a lot of black and Mexican friends. In fact, I had one white friend growing up in Texas. The rest were black or Mexican. So, yeah, I got into a lot of fights and called a lot of names, race traitor and everything. However, that being said, same people who called me that today, I ran into them, and they are full-blown racist. Everything that's wrong is the black man's fault. Everything right is because of the white man, and it's just fucked up. And a lot of them that are like that, well, to be honest, the smoking that crystal meth shit, which is further rotting out their brains. So think about that. Like, however, the true liberals, not the libtards, the liberals, were for, you know, yeah, all right, they were for, you know, gay people, rights for them, rights for the women, and, you know, rights for the African American people, which is all well and good. I'm behind those. You know, hey, no problem. But then they were also for, you know, smaller government. You know, they were against big business. They were against, you know, us building up nuclear arms. Because, hey, we got to store them somewhere, and people didn't want them stored around them. You know, they were against nuclear power plants, and they were for the environment and this planet. So, you know, yeah, the libtards took the liberal ideas that they had, which were well and good. Some of them I believe in. But then the libtards took those liberal ideas, and they could have went what's considered conservative with them, or they could have went way out past left field, out towards socialism and communism with them. And the libtards went the way of communism, Nazi, totalitarianism, dictatorship with it. The libtards want government to give us everything free. Don't have to work for shit. If someone works and you don't want to work, not saying you can, not saying you're disabled, just saying, you know what? I don't feel like working. Fuck it. The government will give me money. Fuck it. I don't want to work. Well, the libtards say that guy should get the same money as the man busting his ass 40, 50, 60, 80 hours a week. No. Disability is different. Those of us on disability have it a different way. I worked, I can't work anymore, I'm disabled, so I get money. Then you get the people that were born with disabilities where they can't work. So Uncle Sam gives us a bit. And then you got the people who did work and are now retired, and the money they put into Social Security, they get back. Alright, libtards, like I said, are against working and against America having borders or being its own sovereign nation. The liberals, on the other hand, are for borders, for us being our own nation, and for everyone who can, working. You know, this is going to be a relatively short video, but, you know, I just thought that I'd mention the differences between liberals and libtards. Liberals, I understand. Hell, I can respect them and have a conversation with them. A lot of them are pretty intelligent. But when it comes to libtards, well, how to put this nicely? I don't respect them because they don't respect me. They're the dumbest sons of bitches that were to ever grace God's green earth. No fucking idea what they're talking about except the parrot, whatever the current talking point is for the lying media. And they don't think for themselves. They're like human forms of parrots or macaws or cockatoos, the ones that can imitate human talk. You know, we say, Polly want a cracker? Polly want a cracker? The parrot, ah! Polly want a cracker? Polly want a cracker? Ah! Polly want a cracker? Polly want a cracker? Who's a pretty bird?
I'm a pretty bird. I'm a pretty bird. I'm a pretty bird. I'm a pretty bird.
They don't know what they're saying, but they know that if, when asked this question, this is the response to give if they want a treat, a cracker or whatever. Well, libtards are the same way. The lying media puts out a talking point, boom, they're parroting it. Because they want a treat. And their treat is the government giving them everything. They don't have to work. They don't seem to understand that if you go to college and you get a degree, yes, you have debt, but the reason that degree means something is because not a lot of people have it. Not a lot of people have a degree in engineering or being a doctor. That's why engineers, let's say rocket engineers, get paid the big bucks, and so do doctors. But and they understand that if everybody has that degree, then it's going to cheapen it and make it basically worthless. The libtards don't get the idea that if everybody has the degree in something, then it's going to be worthless. Let's take for instance, if everybody had a degree in sociology and psychiatry, let's say, then being a psychologist or a psychiatrist, you wouldn't get paid shit. You'd be lucky to get minimum wage. Why? Because everybody has that degree. Everybody has that piece of paper, which now means it's worth less than if a few people had it. You see, if only, say, 7.6 billion, 9.8, billion people on the planet. Let's say 20 people out of everybody on the planet, only 20